Alrighty, folks, here was an interesting one. We got this file in here, and urgent, bad file, customer can't open it, quite a big file. And yeah, please help. We have our recovery service. We offer to fix on a no cure, no pay situation your bad InDesign files. In lieu of a product, like for Quark, we have Mark's Tools, which you can pay $199 for, and it works 80 or so percent of the time to fix your files. In this case, we just do the service because you don't have a product yet for it. It also works about 80% of the time, which is pretty amazing. Anyway, here was an interesting one. We took the file, and of course, we always first try to see what happens in InDesign. We dropped it on InDesign, and we got this. Use one or more plugins currently not available on your system. Do you want to try anyway? Conditional text and Word WorldReady. We're going to try it anyway, and we'll zoom out and see what happens. Well, what you see immediately, you get the old spinning beach ball. Never a good sign. And then the watch set at 9 o'clock sharp, not doing anything. And then we get the message, cannot open. All right, so I was just curious what happens if we try our recovery method of going through Quark and ID to Q, our conversion tool to open in Quark, and then reopen it in InDesign from Quark via Q to ID, our Quark to InDesign plugin. Well, what happened when I went to Quark, I'm not going to do it on now because it basically takes a long time. In this case, it was a very big file, and obviously these plugins add a lot of data that can be difficult to work with. It crashed Quark when we were using Q to ID, but we did get a rescue file, which is very handy in Quark, by the way. Something InDesign doesn't offer, it lets you try to see if you can do something with the file. In this case, the file was convertible with InDesign. I'm not going to share that either because it also takes about half an hour. Obviously, something was very different than these files in the normal file. In any event, it does open eventually, and we get this, which will pop open, just to show you that the file that we have here, and then the fixed one here, how the process actually works, how we can actually open this file for the customer. Yeah, we'll get some missing font warnings, of course, and stuff like that, but basically what you see here is we now can get into this file and get at the content, and this customer can now get to work doing whatever it is they need to do on this pretty complex, large file here. Multiple pages here of a lot of design work, a lot of content. And one thing I liked here is their slogan. Quality is a product of a good attitude. And with that in mind, let's take this same file and show you our new FlightCheck. FlightCheck Professional version 6.5 is now out with Adobe InDesign CS4, Illustrator, PDF, QuarkXPress 8, etc. support. And this is just a really great tool to help you check and look inside files without having to pry through everything and hope to find a problem in this huge document here, which would likely take forever. Another nice thing about FlightCheck is it also can collect your files, all your fonts and images, packages they call it in InDesign, and very handy for Illustrator users because they don't have that option, Adobe and Illustrator, and we can collect all your files from your Illustrator file, all your fonts and placed images. So let's see what FlightCheck tells us here on this file. FlightCheck goes through and scans all the elements of your file, looking for well over 300 potential problems to report back to you. Anything ranging from the missing font to the missing image down to transparency issues, hairlines, and more technical issues like ICC profile usage, trapping, overlapping, etc. You see the eagle working hard, the eagle eye looking deep within your file, much like an X-ray, to help you very quickly understand what's the technical makeup of this file, and are there any problems that you should zoom right into first to fix before even going deeper into the file. Yes, it'll tell you exactly where the problems are, the pages, and even help you navigate to the problem. Okay, so here we see it. A full report. Anything in blue is a warning. Red is a flat-out error, as we set up in our ground controls. And I'm not going to give you a full demo now. I'll link to where the full demo is. I just want to show you some of the cool basic uses of FlightCheck, and you can research it further yourself. We see here there's ICC profile used. We have different issues that we can zoom in on, and good point, I'll zoom in too, so you can see some of the different various issues that we can help you find here. RGB may be a problem, maybe not for you, depends on that. Here's one I like, is the small point size. We can see exactly where a particular font is used below a particular font size, which you set in the ground controls to go look at. So let's now go look at the main screen where we get a complete overview of the file, and we can see information, general information.